Bonnie the Lunatic, all 5 feet, 4 inches, and 120 pounds of her, co-founder of the Wasatch Roller Derby.
So Honey the Lunatic tends to yell a lot.
Hit her! Hit her! Hit her!
She yells while she's playing.
Go! Go!
On the sidelines.
Stop!
When we're not playing roller derby.
You've missed a lot.
When we are playing roller derby.
I won't get you, China! I won't get you!
She has a little bit of a yelling problem.
Keep going! Keep going! Stop!
Now, meet Lacey Matthews Peterson, a registered dietitian and certified diabetes educator at the University of Utah's Diabetes Center.
I became interested in diabetes because I did a hospital rotation and saw how so many people had diabetes, but they were not getting education. They didn't know how to take care of it. Once I started practicing and teaching people about nutrition, I saw what an impact it had on their lives and how I could make such a difference teaching them certain principles that would help them to improve their blood sugars.
Did you ever get back to Emma Jean about doing the recipe exchange?
I make a difference in people's lives every single day, whether it be following consistent carbohydrates or carbohydrate counting or testing their blood sugars more. From that, we can see a significant impact right there in the numbers. After work, many nights I spend my time playing roller derby. When I talk to people about physical activity, I also tell them how I play roller derby, and it's amazing the different ways that you can become active.
Roller derby is one of the fastest growing recreational sports in the country, especially among women, with leagues stretching out from coast to coast. Several teams have included players who've competed successfully while dealing with diabetes.
About a year ago, I had some friends who were actually on the Mission City Brawl and Betty's, and they kept going up to me saying, hey, this is so much fun, you gotta get out there. But you know what? I'm not so sure I wanna get beat up and bruised and banged and hit. And then I went out and saw a game. I said, I gotta be a part of this.
It's not often that you find women playing a full contact sport, and I think that's one of the things that's great about it. You get to be whoever you want to be, and you get to hit people really hard doing it.
When they host league games, Lacey and her crew raise money for charity.
We just want to give as much money as we possibly can to those organizations. So we try to give at least 40% of our net proceeds to charity. One of the things that has brought us here is we gave money to the American Diabetes Association.
But Lacey isn't the only member of the Wasatch Midnight Terrors who has a connection to diabetes.
I have an aunt and uncle and several cousins with type 1 diabetes, so it's something we live with. I just recently remarried, and my stepdaughter has type 1 diabetes since she was 4. So diabetes affects us every single day. That's why we're here, to be athletic, to be healthy, to promote fitness, and that's what we do here at Wasatch Roller Derby.
I'm one of those people who likes to talk about it because I find everybody knows somebody who has diabetes. And it's one of those diseases that when people hear about it, they want to help. You know, it's like, oh, what can I do? Or, well, what is that all about? Just because I have diabetes doesn't make me any different or any less strong or any less motivated, and you don't have to have limits just because you have diabetes.
Lacey says it's only a matter of time before one of her patients actually joins the team.
I would love for somebody to come and join our league who has diabetes. Why not? Any woman can do it. Any age, any size.
Keep going. You're not tired, you're only 20.
Anything. Everybody's welcome to roller derby.